Hello students, welcome to the online classes of social studies. Today we will do chapter 1 of geography. The chapter is the earth and the solar system. You must have already studied about the solar system in the previous class. We know the solar system consists of the sun and 8 planets. You have already read the sun and the planet as part of the solar system. At night you must have seen many stars in the sky. You have also read about sun is also a star. So you know that solar system is sun and the star, and even sun is also a star, and there are 8 planets. So let's continue. The sun and the stars. Our sun is much closer to us than any other star. Light from the sun takes about 8 minutes to reach the earth. But the light from the next nearest star takes several years to reach us. So in this paragraph it is said that the sun is very close to us than any other star. There are many stars, but sun is very close to us. And that's why it looks quite big. Light from the sun, the light which is coming from the sun, it reaches to the earth in approximately 8 minutes. But there are other stars' light, which is next one close to the earth after the sun, its light is taking at least several years to reach to the earth. So what the basic this paragraph is telling us, the sun is also a star. It is close to the earth, that's why it looks big. And the light of the sun is reaching to the earth in 8 minutes. And the next star, which is close to the earth, that light is reaching in several years. So we can imagine how far the stars are from us. How much is the distance? Okay. Stars are so far away, they look like points of light. The stars are very, very far from the earth. That's why they look only like a dot or a point of light. Actually, they are very, very huge, but they appear very small because of the distance they are situated from the earth. They are giant balls of hot gas, just like the sun. So all the stars are made up of hot gases. Sun is also made up of hot gases. So all stars are giant balls, big balls of hot gases, even the sun. Every star has a life cycle. So all star including sun has a life cycle. They are young, grow into middle age, and they eventually die. So they have a life cycle. So they are very small, then they grow, and eventually they die off also. Stars change as they age, but these changes are very slow and happen over millions of years and therefore not noticeable. So stars change when they grow, but these changes are very, very minute and they take millions of years. Therefore, we do not notice it. So stars are changing, but very, very minutely, and the change occurs, those changes take millions of years, so we are not able to notice those changes. Next we have that when the stars burn, all the hydrogen in its core begins to die. So slowly, slowly hydrogen gas which is present in the stars dies off. Our sun is now about halfway through its middle age, and it is estimated that it will continue to give us light and heat for another 500 million years. So we know that sun is also a star. It also has a life cycle, small, then growing into middle age, then age when it is going to die. But we know that it is estimated that the sun will sun has reached at the middle age. And at least for 500 million years more, it will be emitting light and heat. The largest stars can be 10 times larger in diameter than the sun. So largest stars can be 10 times bigger than the sun's diameter. Okay, larger in their diameter than sun. Such stars are called giant stars, those stars which are bigger than the sun, their diameter is bigger than the sun, they are called as giant stars. The smallest stars are not much bigger than the planet Jupiter, and small stars are not bigger than the Jupiter. The coolest star nearly 500 degrees, while the hottest stars can reach up to 90,000 degrees. Cool stars appear red and hot stars appear bluish white. So the cool stars will have temperature of at least 500 degrees. You can imagine now the temperature is 45, 44, 42. We feel so hot. So if the temperature is 500 degrees, what will be the condition? So the stars which are cool, they have 500 degree temperature, and the stars which are hot, they have 90,000 degree Celsius temperature. The cool stars will appear red in color and the hot stars will appear bluish white in color. Next we have universe. The universe can be defined as totally or totality of all that exists, be it stars, sun, moon, and everything around us. So universe is everything that exists. It can be stars, moons, planets, and everything all around which is existing is universe. The universe includes all the celestial bodies. Celestial bodies means heavenly bodies. All the animals, plants, minerals, gases, everything you can see, feel or sense, everything comes under universe. So all the planets, stars, moons, satellites, asteroids, meteors, comets, plants, animals, minerals, gases, everything we can see, everything we can feel or sense, all that comes under universe. So universe is very, very, very vast. Our earth is just like a dot into it. Even things that are in the space outside the earth that cannot be seen are part of the universe. So the things which we cannot see outside the space, we are on the earth, and when we go to the space, there are so many things. Other planets are there, asteroids, meteors, comets. So all that will be also the part of universe. So huge is the universe. Nebula. Nebula is very huge mass of gas and dust. So nebula is a ball of huge ball of gas and dust. It is nebula that creates celestial body. From the nebula only the celestial bodies have come out. All the stars formed by nebula, and thus it is also called the mother of all stars and celestial bodies. So all the stars have come out from the nebula. That's why from the nebula or to the nebula we can call mother of all stars. So nebula is a cloud of a huge gas, mass of gas and dust from where the stars have originated. Okay. That's why it is called as mother of all stars and celestial bodies. Stars. Stars are huge mass of burning gases. They emit light and heat. That's the important point to notice, that stars have their own heat and light, whereas planets do not have heat and light. We get the heat and light from the stars. So stars are huge mass of burning gases. They have their own heat and light. Stars are of varying sizes and very far apart. Some stars are very big, some small, and they are situated on very big distance. Far apart they are situated. What you see at night is just a fraction of total number of stars present in the universe. So what we see at night now, that is only very small amount of stars that we can see. There are millions and millions of stars that we cannot see as they are situated very, very far from the Earth. So the stars which we see at night is very, very few amount of, a less amount of what exists actually in the universe. Next we have constellations. So some stars have a similarity in the position and movement, and therefore they look like fixed pattern in the sky. Such patterns are called constellations and have been given names. So constellation means some stars have a fixed or similar pattern of being existed and movement. They form a pattern and they look when you see in the sky. So they are called as constellation and they have different names. Like commonly known constellations are Cassiopeia, the Ursa Major, the Orion's Belt, the Ursa Minor, etc. So these are the some groups of constellation. They have a pattern of, they form a design, similar design or pattern. In the Hindi, the constellation Ursa Major is also known as Saptarishi. The meaning is seven sages. This name of Saptarishi is very old, taken from the Vedas and Upanishads. So they have been helpful in finding the direction since early times. So the Ursa Major, which is called as Saptarishi, is used for finding the direction, in that the star points the northern north direction. Now with new technology, ships and people do not use this much for the navigational purpose. But now the new technologies have come. Otherwise, in olden days, people used to see this Saptarishi and find out the direction and move accordingly. Since we have got the new technology, so the people in ships or people those who are traveling or having technologies in navigational purpose, now they use the new technologies.